A nossa próxima convidada é uma escritora do Reino Unido, cujo novo livro, A Última Duquesa, chegou agora às livrarias portuguesas. Por favor, é Daisy Goodman. Hi, Daisy.
Hi.
So nice to have you here.
So nice to be here.
Thank you so much. I was looking over your book, and I found it so fascinating, this world, like two worlds colliding almost.
Yes.
An American girl coming to Europe. Why did you want to tell the story?
Oh, I just love the idea of, you know, this brash American girl with loads of money coming to England and being put into this really stuffy atmosphere, you know.
Uh-huh.
I don't know if you've seen Downton Abbey, but,
yeah,
you know, like this world where there is kind of, you know, people are very repressed.
Yeah,
and
very
then downstairs
off.
You've got the servants and they're all watching you all the time. And I just thought it was a great start for a drama. You know, and
that used to happen a lot. It takes place in late 19th century, right?
That's right.
And it used to happen a lot to try to combine like a title with the American money and,
yeah,
try to make it work, right?
It happened all the time. So like in 1895, there was a real woman called Consuelo Vanderbilt,
mm-hmm,
and she married the Duke of Marlborough, and her fortune was, in today's money, $100 million. So you could see why all these English aristocrats were desperate to marry an American. Yeah.
How did you get the idea for this movie? Was it based on that story?
Yeah,
that
it was based on that story. I was walking around Blenheim Palace where she used to live, and I saw a picture of her, and she looked very unhappy. So I thought it would be really interesting to kind of figure out a little bit about what it would be like to be, you know, somebody who's got all the money in the world, but you can't buy happiness.
Right. And how do you research for that? Because you really have to. Sorry. You really have to get into it and
yeah,
into the characters and what it would be like to, you know, come to Europe and everything is different and people talk different and.
Yeah. Well, that was the fun part. The research was so much fun because I spent a lot of time, you know, reading books of the period and, mm-hmm, looking at all the pictures of their clothes. And one of the things I did, I tried on a corset that, you know, my
you really
heroine would have worn, and it's incredible. You can't bend over, you're just like this the whole time.
Oh my God.
So it was really good for getting myself into character.
You
know.
You had to go through it yourself.
Yeah.
Então a Jane escreveu este livro, A Última Duquesa, que fala então de uma rapariga americana que casa com um duque inglês. Era muito comum então virem pessoas com muito dinheiro dos Estados Unidos para casar com alguém com um título e juntar então assim as duas coisas. A Daisy fez então muita pesquisa sobre este período, vestiu inclusivamente um corpete para se sentir na pele desta personagem. And do you travel a lot while you research?
Yes,
that's
I had so much fun. I went to America and I went to see all these mansions on the East Coast where Cora grows up, you, mm-hmm, know, and they're just these huge palaces. And they were just amazing. And then I went to look at some sort of stately homes and I looked at where the servants lived and I just got sort of the details so that I could write about it convincingly.
You picked an American so you can go to America and,
yeah,
search,
obviously,
right?
Yeah.
It's for the traveling.
Yeah, of course, yeah. But unfortunately, I couldn't get, I wasn't able to go on the sort of yacht. She had her own, mm-hmm, yacht and her own train, you know.
Well,
yeah.
Next
I missed
time.
Out on that. Yeah, next time, definitely.
But what are you like while you're writing? This is your first novel.
Yes.
Already a bestseller. So
yeah,
congratulations
I've been
for that.
Yeah, I've been very lucky. Yeah.
Were you surprised about that?
Yeah,
New
I was
York
amazed. Yeah, I was thrilled. Yeah, I you know, because in England maybe because I did a bit of TV in England, mm-hmm, but in America I wasn't expecting it at all. So I was thrilled, and also because if you're writing about an American for an American audience,
right,
you have to hope that you get it right.
And you
know?
Have to be really careful about every little detail because
yeah,
you know
exactly.
They're
going
to
be pouncing on you. Yes.
Oh God. Well,
fantastic.
Congratulations because
you
made
so
it.
Much.
A Daisy, então, o livro da Daisy foi lançado nos Estados Unidos, best-seller do New York Times. Ela nem sequer estava à espera disto. Uma inglesa a escrever sobre uma rapariga americana, por isso é mesmo fantástico que isto tenha acontecido. But I wanted to know, while you're writing, well, specifically this book, do you close yourself off? Do you like disconnect everything while you're focusing on the story?
I wish. I run a TV company in London,
uh-huh,
and I've got two children. So I have to write when, you know, I can. So I'm writing on trains. I have headphones,
right,
and I sit there with my noise cancelling headphones like this. You know, on the plane home, I'll be writing. So I have to write when and if I can. So I'm very good at switching myself, everything out, and just focusing. When I have an hour free, I'll write.
And did you know where you wanted to take the story when you started writing it? Did you have everything planned out, or does it just come along?
Well, no, I did have it all planned out, but then I started to write. My characters did that spooky thing. They took over.
Oh, yeah.
And they were like, had a life of their own.
Do you dream about your characters? Do you have dreams about them?
Yeah. Sadly. No, well, not too much. I'm not completely.
But sometimes they can take over your life.
Yeah, and they became very real. And I sort of thought, no, she's not going to do that. And I'd sit down to write, and suddenly something completely different would happen to what I had planned. So it's quite an interesting
experience. That's just the magic
experience.
Of writing,
I wasn't expecting that at all.
And do any of the characters have things from you, like characteristics or things
people,
you would say?
My husband says I'm horribly like Cora. Spoiled.
Really?
She's very spoiled. Okay. My husband said, yeah, I know where she's coming
from. So it's
from.
Like an alter ego type of thing.
Yeah, I think she's quite like me when I was 18, except I'm not massively rich like she was. So
well, maybe someday with bestsellers.
Yeah. Hello,
come
yeah.
on. Até então, eu perguntei-lhe como é que é ela a escrever, se ela se fecha para o mundo para escrever os seus livros. Mais ou menos, ela tem dois filhos, é casada, é produtora de televisão também. Por isso, qualquer horinha que tenha livre é nisso que ela se foca. Perguntei também se as personagens tomam conta dela, e de vez em quando isso acontece, às vezes ela até tem sonhos com as personagens, e se as personagens tinham alguma coisa dela própria, e a personagem principal, a Cora, segundo o marido aqui da Daisy, tem algumas coisas dela. You're getting this. You're smiling at me. You're getting what I'm saying. I read that you're working already on your next one.
Yes, I'm writing the next one.
And it's about Cece.
Yes,
right?
About Cece, yeah. Yes, another woman in a corset.
I love it.
Yeah.
So you're flying to Austria anytime
Yeah,
soon?
I've been flying to Austria. I'm eating a lot of Sachertorte. I'm having a great time. Yes.
Okay. You're doing this for the travelling,
I
course. Can see that.
Yeah, it's all for the travel. It's tax deductible. That's all you want.
That's fabulous. Yeah. And since you're a TV producer, are you thinking of turning this into a series?
Well, I'm very lucky because this guy called Darren Star, who made Sex in the City, has bought the rights. So I'm hoping he will turn it into a film.
Do you need a Portuguese girl to play an American
living
in the UK?
You look very like Cora to me.
Okay,
You'd be
fantastic. We're done. I am very much done here, people. Thank you very much. I'll see you soon. Daisy, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you so much.
A pleasure talking to you.
Obrigado.
Of course, she speaks Portuguese. Thank you so much. It was such a pleasure. Daisy, então, já foi abordada pelo senhor que fez o Sex and the City. Talvez isto venha a ser uma série. Temos livros para oferecer. You brought some.
Yes,
some books.
Yes,
yeah,
yes.
We're giving them out. Passem no Facebook no final do programa. You also have a Facebook page and
yes,
a website.
Yes, I've got a Facebook page. I'm on Twitter. You know, I'm everywhere. Daisy Goodwin UK. Yeah.
Faça like, Daisy. Thank you so much for being here.
Oh,
such
thank you so much.
João, novidades.